It is time to saddle up for the newest movie based on a best-selling book from Nicholas Sparks. It's called The Longest Ride, stars Scott Eastwood and Britt Robertson, and it's about a professional bull rider and a college student who meet and sparks fly right away. Take a look.
Luke.
Sophia.
Nice to meet you, Sophia. Can I get you a drink?
Well, you were the big winner tonight, right? I think I should be the one buying you a beer.
Oh, no. It doesn't work like that where I'm from.
Okay. You're buying.
This is an odd clip.
Scott and okay, you were just saying that's a weird clip. Why?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know if it...
There's no context. It's just go for it. The first meet and greet, you know.
I know, but actually this is good. Here's why it works, because I do think from the get-go there's some sparks that fly. I mean, you guys have chemistry, which you need. Did you know right away, Scott? Okay, Britt, she's in the role. Like, this is going to work.
You know, they ask this question a lot. Do we know?
Yeah.
I don't think we do.
We had no idea. No. I mean, we just tried to do the best that we could, become as comfortable as we could with each other, and then hope that someone, you know, thought we had chemistry or that it would work.
You're relatively new to this business. You're not novices. What's it like to be, all right, here you are. You're the leading man and woman in a major film. Pretty exciting?
Yeah. Yeah, it's really exciting.
I mean,
what an honor to be a part of such a great film.
Scott's handling it really well. I enjoy it. It's really cool, but it feels surreal in a weird way. Like, it doesn't feel any different from my life, but yet it is very different from normal life.
Have you come up with any, like, celebrity diva up things yet? I mean, you could ask for, like, candles in your dressing room, maybe some, like, lavender lilies for you,
Scott.
No, but
I'd love a nap. I'd love a nap.
Yes.
I'd love for them to schedule in, like, a lunch break. That would be awesome.
This busy, right? So the bull riding is kind of the context to the film. There's some great bull riding scenes, so guys, you can go to this movie and like it.
Yeah, this is,
But I heard you were kind of bummed out. You didn't actually get to do the bull riding in the movie.
Yeah, I pressed Fox pretty hard, and they pushed back. So ultimately, I went and did it after the fact, as you can see here.
You really did see it. So it's not one of those, oh, boy, wish I could do
there
the stunts, but darn, they won't let me. There you are. How long did you stay up on that bull?
I think about 2.5 seconds. Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah,
that's really good.
Two and a half seconds longer than you or I, probably, right?
I did the fakie, you know, the mechanical bull, and I lasted like a half a second. It was so sad.
This is a Nicholas Sparks novel. Many of us remember and treasure The Notebook.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
As I understand it, one of us here cried at The Notebook.
Wasn't me.
I did cry at The Notebook.
You know what? It's a point of pride. Matt Lauer and Al Roker cried at The Notebook.
Oh.
I cry every time it's on.
You obviously have a famous last name.
Mm-hmm.
You have a famous father, Clint Eastwood.
Yeah, I heard of him. Yeah.
But you've never really wanted to play that card. I heard that even in your first auditions, you used your mother's maiden name.
Yeah. About 12 years ago, when I started auditioning in the business, I used my mom's last name just to see if I could do it for me.
Yeah. Why did that feel important? I mean, did you kind of wonder, people will think, it's famous star's son, and that's why he's getting these breaks?
Yeah. And I think they probably, you know, would have said that anyways. And you sort of realize pretty early on that you got to go out and audition like everybody.
So. Have you ever auditioned for your dad?
Oh, yeah. Every film I've been in of his, I've auditioned for.
Yeah.
And some I haven't gotten roles
well,
in.
Well, I was about to ask you, has he ever said, and how does that conversation go? Son, I like you. I really do. But.
No, there's no conversation. You just don't get a phone call back.
Wait, your dad disses you. No call.
Well, it's not,
he calls for Sunday dinner, but not for the part.
Yeah.
You're like, is there anything else you wanted to ask me? And Britt, you, I think, must have the coolest grandma in the world. You grew up in the Carolinas, but you left, I guess, when you were, 12 or 13?
Super young,
With your grandma, she wanted you to be a star.
Yeah, she did.
She took you to L.A., right?
She moved to L.A. with me. Wow. My mom, you know, I have six younger brothers and sisters, so both of my families were trying to just keep them in check, and my grandmother decided to move out to L.A. with me so that I could pursue the dream.
Well, she's awesome, and can I just say, I was a little surprised, Scott, that you came here with a whole shirt on, because I've checked out your Instagram feed, and the shirt is not something we see very much.
Well,
and by the way, there's your dad on the left, so you have to
look, he's shirtless as well, you know. Well, we're California guys, both my dad and I, and, you know, there's the beach in California. Not so much beach here.
He's a free spirit.
He is indeed. It's good to have you both here.
Hey,
congrats on the movie,
thank
guys.
You.
It opens this Friday. It's called The Longest Ride. By the way, their co-star Alan Alda will be here in our next hour.